The choice facing French voters is stark. 11 candidates with radically different visions of what the future should be. Of them, the two frontrunners have almost diametrically opposed proposals. On one hand, a stronger relationship with Europe and a tough approach to Russia. On the other, a referendum on leaving the EU and a closer relationship with Moscow. It's a rapprochement that Marine Le Pen has already started working on with a visit to Moscow. Vladimir Putin took the opportunity to state Russia's position.
We do not want to influence events in any way.
But inside Emmanuel Macron's headquarters, the fear is that Moscow has been trying to help Marine Le Pen. His campaign manager says they are being targeted by both cyber attacks and fake news.
Emmanuel Macron wants a strong European Union. And we know that the strategy of those countries that don't want a strong Europe means making him lose the election.
So is Russia interfering in France's presidential campaign, as it is alleged to have done in the American poll? France's internet watchdog has warned of the danger of cyber interference. We asked an expert on French cybersecurity whether he thought Russia was involved.
Yeah, probably. Just like the United States has been interfering in many, many presidential elections around the world for the past, 50 years at least, just like France has been interfering in almost every African presidential election since, 60, 70 years. It's the way democracy works around the world.
The trouble, says Fabrice, is that it is impossible, given the sophistication of the technology, to determine where a particular hack originated. CNN reached out to the Kremlin to get their response. A spokesman said, "We strongly disagree with these accusations. They are groundless. Moscow was not involved in any cyber attacks and can't be involved." So what about fake news? At the French daily Le Monde, a special unit was set up in which 12 journalists work to identify and debunk fake news. Adrien Seneca tells us that the French presidential campaign has seen partisan news from Russian media, but not fake news, that is, news stories that are entirely made up. They have tended, he says, to come from inside France.
The top stories that were wrong this past couple of months on the French internet were mostly being made up by far-right websites or far-right partisans or far-right Facebook pages. And they mostly targeted migrants or medias or Emmanuel Macron.
For those inside Emmanuel Macron's campaign headquarters, fake news stories targeting their candidate are all the more worrying because of the nature of his electorate. It is untested because he's never stood before, and the polls suggest much more volatile than Marine Le Pen's. In short, he has many more people to convince, and the fear here is that some may be all too easily put off. Melissa Bell, CNN in Paris.